Statistical inference is a pretty confusing thing, so I want to just give you a little bit more intuitive understanding about what the point of all of it is. Suppose that there are some people who just are always going to have a high value of their outcome. You know, they're always going to, let's say, get a lot of education. Then suppose there are some other people who are just always not going to go to school for one reason or another. Okay, so we've got two kinds of people, the people that always get lots of education and the people who don't. Now suppose we have some treatment, you know, we give some people a lollipop, okay? And let's just assume we already know that the treatment effect is zero, okay? Because there's no reason to expect that giving people a lollipop is going to change their minds about whether they go to college or not, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to do an experiment. We're going to randomly assign some people to get a lollipop and some people not. Now, it can happen just by chance that all the people who are going to go and go to college anyway, they all end up getting in the treatment group. They all get lollipops. And just by chance, all the other people who aren't going to go to college, they don't get lollipops. Okay? Just by chance, because when we randomly assign people, every person has a possibility of being in both groups. So it's possible that people get split up this way. Now, when we do that, we're going to compute a treatment effect of whether you got a lollipop or not on whether you go to college. And what we're going to find is that there's a huge treatment effect. Getting a lollipop makes everyone go to college. So if you want people to go to college, we would conclude from our experiment that you should just give everyone a lollipop. Okay? But that's not actually what's going on. What's actually going on is this random chance put the people who are going to go to college anyway in the lollipop group and the other people in the no lollipop group. Now, the problem here is that we might not have a big enough sample. Okay, the only way that we can get such imbalance is that we have too small of a sample size. Okay, if we have a very, very large sample size, then the probability that we get this kind of allocation is going to go to zero. Okay, it's going to be basically zero, so we don't have to worry about it. That's the whole idea behind randomized experiments as opposed to controlled experiments in the lab, is that when we have very large groups, on average, the two groups are going to be the same. Okay, but in this case, with a specific small number of people, the groups aren't the same, okay, because we haven't had enough. So what hypothesis testing and statistical inference does is it helps us account for this possibility that in real life, we don't have enormous amounts of people in our experiment. We may only have, 100 people in each group, let's say. And so it's possible that we could just have bad luck and randomly assign all the college people to the lollipop group and all the non-college people to the no lollipop group. Okay, so statistical inference is going to help us account for that possibility and make sure that our conclusions are robust to that chance.